Good morning, students. Welcome to your English language class. In your previous lesson, you have done the central idea of the poem, Wear the Mind Without Fear. Today, we are going to do our lesson 54, combination of two or more simple sentences into one simple sentence. After watching this video, you will be able to combine two or more simple sentences into one simple sentence by using participles, absolute phrase, and infinitives. First, we are going to combine two or more simple sentences into one simple sentence by using a participle, that is, present form of verb plus ing. You have already watched the video related to the chapter, the participles. Today, we will combine two simple sentences into one simple sentence by using present participle, that is present form of verb plus ing. For example, running, taking, or we can use past participle, that is third form of verb. For example, tired, exhausted, or we can use perfect participle, that is having plus past participle or being plus past participle. For example, having failed, being tired. We can join two sentences using a participle when there are two different actions and second action happens as a result of first action. For example, he took his hat, he went out. Here first action is he took his hat. Now what is the second action? Second action is he went out. Now we should keep in mind, while using a participle, we have to see the subjects of both the sentences. For example, he took his hat, he went out. In both the sentences, the subject he is the same. Now students, rule number one. If the subjects or the doers of actions in both the sentences are same, then we will begin our sentence with the participle. For example, he took his hat, he went out. Now we will take a verb of the sentence where first action takes place. Now where the first action takes place in this example? First action takes place in he took his hat and the verb is took. So, we will change the verb took into present participle. That is, present form of verb plus ing. So, the answer will be, taking his hat, he went out. Now, we can join the same sentence by using perfect participle. That is, we can use having plus past participle form of verb. Then what will be the answer? The answer will be having taken his hat, comma, he went out. Now students, rule number two. If the verb used in the sentence is, am, are, was, were, then it will be changed into being. For example, he was tired, he sat down to rest. Now in this sentence, both the subjects are same and the helping verb was is used. So was will change into being. Now what will be the answer? Being tired, full stop changes into comma and h should be small. Being tired, comma, he sat down to rest. Let's take one more example. The baby was hungry. The baby cried for milk. In this example, the subject is same, that is the baby, and the helping verb was is used. So was will change into being. So the answer will be the baby, comma, being hungry, comma, cried for milk. or being hungry, comma, the baby cried for milk. Now students, we are going to use an absolute phrase for the combination of two or more simple sentences into one simple sentence. So first, absolute phrases are used to combine two sentences that have different subjects. For example, the visitors left, we went to bed. Here, both the sentences have different subjects. In sentence 1, the subject is the visitors, and in sentence 2, the subject is we. So we will use here having plus past participle form of verb. But students, if subjects in both the sentences are different, then we will begin the sentence with the first subject. So the answer will be the visitors having left, comma, we went to bed. Let's take another example. First, the police arrived, the mob dispersed. Again, subjects are different. First subject is the police and the second subject is the mob. So we will begin with the first subject. Then the answer will be the police having arrived, comma, the mob dispersed. Second example, it was a stormy day. We stayed inside the house. Again, the subjects are different. So, we will begin with the first subject, that is it. And helping verb was is used. So, was will change into being. Then what will be the answer? The answer will be, it being a stormy day, comma, we stayed inside the house. Now students, we are going to do combination of two or more simple sentences into one simple sentence by using an infinitive, that is 2 plus present form of verb. But students, where can we use infinitives? We can use infinitives if we are talking about some purpose. For example, he is going to Mumbai. He will start business there. So what is his purpose for going to Mumbai? His purpose is to start business there. So we can combine the sentences by using 2 plus present form of verb. So the answer will be, he is going to Mumbai to start business there. So here, to start is an infinitive, that is 2 plus present form of verb. Let's take another example. I have to support my family. I want to find a job. Now, why do I want to find a job? What is the purpose here? The purpose to find a job is to support my family. Now here children, keep one thing in your mind. It is not necessary that sentences always come in the same order. Sometimes the purpose is given in the first sentence, like the sentence we are doing right now. Then what will be the answer? The answer will be, I want to find a job to support my family. So we can always arrange the sentences according to the purpose or need. Next example, you must help your brother. It is your duty. Now, what is the purpose in this example? The purpose here is to help your brother. Then what will be the answer? The answer will be, it is your duty to help your brother. Now students, we can also use infinitive in combination with too. For example, health is very important. It must not be neglected. Now students, if you observe in the first sentence, we have been given the word very. And in the second sentence, we have must not. So if we have very in one sentence and other sentence is negative, then we can use TOO with infinitive. Now the steps that you have to follow are, the word very will be replaced with TOO, and the subject plus helping verb plus not will replace into an infinitive, that is 2 plus present form of verb. So the answer will be, health is too important to be neglected. Let's take one more example. He is very honest. He cannot accept the bribe. Here again, we have got very in the one sentence and the other sentence is negative. So we will change very into TOO, and the subject plus helping verb plus not will change into infinitive. Then what will be the answer? So the answer here is, he is too honest to accept the bribe. Now, your homework is solve exercise 177 by using the hints given in your Snap homework. Have a nice day.